Okay, and the answer is Apache-22.3. Now, if you put in big IP, we accepted that, but I'm pretty sure you didn't use urllib2, because when I was finding the answer to this, I also cheated, used curl, and got big IP, which is actually what www.example.com uses, but urllib2 automatically follows redirects, and the server it redirects to uses Apache. So let me show you how I got the example, and then we'll go ahead and talk about what happened with the redirect. Okay, so the way I found this answer is I used urllib2. I used the URL open function to hit www.example.com. I stored that in a variable, and then I looked at its headers, and I see that the server is Apache-22.3, and that's the correct answer. If we look at the URL attribute on P, we see it's actually iana.org. Now, if you remember from unit one, I asked you what is the location header when you hit www.example.com, and that was because, and this was the answer, because example.com redirects to iana.org. Now, urllib2 automatically follows redirects, which can sometimes be confusing. And in this case, it automatically followed the redirect. It hit iana.org, and whose server is Apache. But if we were to do this by hand, I'm going to use curl. This is the unit one example. We can see that the server is actually big IP. So hopefully you used urllib2, but if you cheated like I did when I was writing this quiz and you saw big IP, we'll also accept that. And it's important to know when you're using these libraries that a lot of these libraries, urllib2, the default one included with Google App Engine called urlfetch, they follow redirects automatically. And if you don't want it to follow the redirect, say you are writing a grading script for your homeworks, you need to look up the docs, and there's almost always an option to tell the library not to automatically follow redirects. So that's something to keep in mind when you get behavior you don't expect, as just happened to me. Okay, let's move on.